For the first time, the world is hearing Timothy McVeigh's confession.
And we're getting reaction from the woman he communicated with while on death row. New at 10, Eyewitness News Five's Mark Opgrande has the story. Mark, you talked to former KOCO reporter Terri Watkins.
Yeah, that's right. Terri says she talked with McVeigh dozens of times through letters, and not once did he ever confess. But she also says that on many of those occasions, he simply ignored her questions.
In the nearly three dozen letters former KOCO reporter Terri Watkins received from Timothy McVeigh, she says you never knew what he would talk about next.
They would range from being mad at Bob Macy and going off on prosecutors, federal and state, to talking about what was going on in prison. And you never knew what was going to show up.
Terri says McVeigh would avoid many of her questions and may have been upset toward the end of his life, believing she was not asking serious enough ones.
I thought, why did you decide to pick Oklahoma City was a pretty weighty question. But the guys from Buffalo are the ones that he wanted to ask and answer that question to.
Two journalists from Buffalo, New York did ask those questions, and they recorded McVeigh's answers. Much of his anger toward the government came from watching the siege at Waco.
The rules of engagement, if not written down, are defined by the actions of an aggressor. Okay? Now, what rules of engagement would you interpret in examining Waco? Kids are fair game, women are fair game.
And on tape, McVeigh said he was only fighting back.
With Oklahoma City being a counterattack, I was only fighting by the rules of engagement that were introduced by the aggressor. Waco started this war. Hopefully Oklahoma would end it.
Terri Watkins believes the audio recordings are one more way for McVeigh to spread his message of hate. But it's also possible they could serve to heal.
Hopefully. And just hopefully that by talking about it, we can dissipate the anger and we can deal with it. And I don't think we'll ever understand it, though.
And Terri says in many of those letters, McVeigh tried to justify his actions. But she says in the end, he was simply a murderer and nothing more. Live in the newsroom, Mark Opgrande, Eyewitness News 5.